Hello Vivekians, welcome to the next session of School from Home. I am your English teacher Gaganpreet, and today we are going to begin with a very interesting chapter, that is chapter number 5, Mulla Nasruddin and the Nail. Students, I hope you all have heard the stories of Akbar and Birbal, where Birbal uses his wit, his presence of mind and his sharp brain and come out of various problems. So today we are going to read one such story about a person, Mulla Nasruddin. The character of Mulla Nasruddin is thought to be based on a real person who lived about 700 years ago, and he can be called as a trickster. Trickster means someone who plays tricks on other, or someone who gets tricked by himself. So he used to play tricks on others. He used his presence of mind, his intelligence, and he used to play tricks on others. So I hope you're all excited to read this interesting chapter, Mulla Nasruddin and the Nail. Mulla Nasruddin, he was a priest in a small village and lived in extreme poverty. No one knew that either he was a madman or a wise man, because no one understood his ways of doing work, and his mind was so engaged in spiritual activities that he never thought about material comfort. Material comfort means thinking about money and luxuries. So he was always busy with his spiritual work. Now what happened is that the debts means udhar. The debts accumulated. Unke upar jo udhar ikattha hota raha. And his credit vanished. Credit means jo bhi unke paas paise wagaira tha, wo dheere dheere khatam hote rahe. And at last, he was left with no other alternative but to sell his ancestral home. तो end में उधार चुकाने के लिए उनके पास कुछ नहीं बचा, तो एक ही option था कि वो अपना जो पूर्वजों का घर था, the ancestral home, he had to sell that. Now, when this plan was made that he'll sell his ancestral home, so Nasruddin had a neighbor who was a very dishonest man. He was large, he had bushy mustache, and he was the person who knew that Mulla Nasruddin was in financial difficulty. So he thought of taking advantage of the situation, and he behaved as if he was a very good neighbor, he was a kind-hearted person, and he said that he would buy the house from Mulla Nasruddin. So because he knew that Mulla Nasruddin was in difficulty, so he offered very pitiful price. Pitiful means very small price. And Mulla Nasruddin happily gave away the house to that person. And he even blessed that person with health. Healthy progeny means health of the children of that person. Okay. And he said that the house shall be yours, but there's a little clause in the contract. Clause. What is a clause? It is a part of agreement, any condition or something. So he said, the house is all yours. He said that to his neighbor, but there was a clause. And what was that clause? So Mulla Nasruddin said, it is a very small thing. Actually, this house was built by my father. And he was a very gentleman person. He always paid in cash. And he said that this house is the last memory of my father. So, if you see that in the living room, on the wall of the living room, there's a small nail. Okay. And he said that my father never got the chance to finish hammering it, and he got a heart attack and died. So, he made a story that his father, he wanted to hammer that nail and put it inside the wall, but before that only he had a heart attack and he died. So, the neighbor, he felt sorry and said that may his soul rest in peace, and he prayed the good for the father's, Mulla Nasruddin's father's soul. And so Mulla Nasruddin said that I request you that you can take away the house. I only want to keep the ownership of that nail. He said that it is the मेमोरी ऑफ माई फादर, सो आई वॉन्ट टू कीप द ओनरशिप कि उस नेल का मालिक जो है मैं रहूं, एंड आई शैल डू वट एवर आई वॉन्ट टू डू विद दैट नेल, रेस्ट हाउस वुड बी योर्स. द नेबर ही एग्रीड, बट ही सेड दैट ही वॉन्टेड टू टॉक विद हिज वाइफ बिफोर साइनिंग द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट. एंड ही वेंट होम, ही डिस्कस्ड द इश्यू विद हिज वाइफ, एंड द वाइफ रेज्ड सम ऑब्जेक्शंस बिकॉज वाइफ न्यू that Mulla was a witty person, he was a clever person. So she said, why is he going to keep the nail? What does it mean? So everyone would think that how can nail be something so important and why to keep a nail? So the husband said that he wants to worship that nail and he is a crazy spiritual person, so I don't think that nail would be such a big issue. And also, they were getting that house for half of its value. They were getting it for such a less amount. So, they both agreed. And the contract was signed. And Mulla Nasruddin moved out of the house. After that, for 1 month, Mulla was not seen. After 1 month, he came and knocked at the door of that house. And the person, he showed very courteous behavior that, where were you? We were wondering about you, how are you, and all those questions. So, Mulla Nasruddin, he said that I have come here to worship that nail. And so the man agreed and Mulla was let inside the house. Now, Mulla, he humbly walked behind the man. He bowed in front of nail. He worshipped it and put his turban on the nail. Wo nail par apni turban jo hai taang dete hai, and he is about to leave. So, when Mulla was leaving, the man asked, what is that doing there? So man asked, why are you leaving that turban over here? So Mulla said, it is my turban. So man said that, yes, it is your turban, but why you are leaving it in my house? So Mulla said that the turban is on my nail and that nail is my property, so I can do that. So somehow the man controlled his anger and Mulla went away. 2 weeks passed and Mulla Nasruddin came back for his next visit. Again, man greeted him. He wished him good morning and asked if Mulla Nasruddin had come back to take his turban. So Mulla said, no, my dear friend, I have come to worship the nail. And this time he didn't take his turban back. He again worshipped the nail, bowed down before the nail. And this time, along with the turban, he hung a scarf and then turned back to leave. The man was not at all happy, but he could not do anything. As Nasruddin declared that he was worshipping his dead father Nail, and the man, he did not know what to do. And he thought that it is the last thing that Mulla could hang that on that small nail. So two things are already hanging there. He would not be able to hang something more. And that's why he allowed the person to go. So that's all for today, students. We'll continue with the same chapter tomorrow. I hope you find this chapter really very interesting. Thank you, students.